Hello and namaskar to everyone. Today we are going to discuss about price leadership by low cost firm. In this model, the firm having low cost determines the price where its marginal revenue is equals to marginal cost. It means the firm having low cost is the price leader. Okay, it's a price leader and it determines the price where it can maximize its profit. So this is the profit maximizing condition, that is MR is equals to MC. And the firms having high cost follow the price of the products. Okay, so the firm having high cost are the price followers and they follow the price of the product. All right. And then the price is determined in such a way that high cost firms also get some profit, but may not be able to maximize profit. So here we know that the price is set by the low cost firm. And this price is determined in such a way that even the high cost firm also gets some profit, but they may not be able to maximize their profit. That is, the condition of MR is equals to MC may not be fulfilled for the high cost firm, right? So moving forward, here, the high cost firms follow the price to avoid price war. As we discussed earlier, the high cost firm, okay, here the high cost firms are the price followers and they follow the price to avoid price war. Once the price war is set, that is, if the price war begins, then the low-cost firm has the capacity to reduce the price up to the level where high-cost firm cannot compete. That's why they follow the price. If they do not follow the price, then they may not be able to compete with the low-cost firm in the market. Okay. Now, having these informations, let's move on to assumptions of this model, price leadership model. And there are some assumptions. The assumptions are, the first assumption is there are only two firms, firm A and firm B. Okay. They have different cost, A being low cost firm and B being high cost firm. So they have different cost and they are producing homogeneous product. Both the firms produce the homogeneous products. Homogeneous product means the products are similar, that is identical in all respects. And the last one is they decide to share the market equally. Okay, there are two cases. Another one is unequal market share. But here we are talking about only about the equal market share, the case of equal market share. So they decide to share the market equally. Okay, on the basis of these assumptions, now we can explain this model, that is the price leadership by low-cost firm, with the help of a diagram or the figure. Now let's move on to the next slide and look at the diagram. Okay, here you can see that output and price are measured, output and price are measured along the x-axis and y-axis respectively. And this is, that is the DM is the market demand curve. This one is the market demand curve. So in the figure, DM is the market demand curve. And as we discussed earlier, there are only two firms and each firm having the same market share. Okay, that's why we can write here, we can see here that DA is the market demand curve for the firm A. And here we can see that the market share of the firm A is this much. Let's say it's 50 units. So if the market share of the firm A is 50 units, then the market share of the firm B is also 50 units. And when we add these two, then we get the total, that is, this person is 100 units. Okay, so market demand is 100 units, and each firm having the equal share means 50 units and 50 units. Okay, so this is the case. That's why here we can see that the demand curve for the firm B overlaps with the firm A. Look at this one. So this is the line I'm drawing, and this overlaps with DA. So this is the demand curve for B, and it overlaps, it coincides with firm A's demand curve. So there are two demand curves. They are coincided with each other. DA is equals to DB. And demand curve is also called average revenue curve. If average revenue curves is this one, then we can draw the marginal revenue curve having this double slope of this demand curve or average revenue curve. Okay, so marginal revenue is MRA is equals to MRB. That means the marginal revenue of firm A is equals to the marginal revenue of the firm B. Okay, now the price leader is the low-cost firm. And look at the diagram. This MCA is the marginal cost curve of firm A. And this is the point, EA, this is the point where marginal revenue is equals to marginal cost. And this is the point of equilibrium. And at this point of equilibrium, we can see that this much, that is, OM is the equilibrium quantity and OP is the equilibrium price. Okay, in this way, price is determined in this type of price leadership model. OP is the price and OM is the quantity, equilibrium quantity of the firm A. But we have already discussed that this is only half of the total market demand. Now let's have total market demand. So this one is OQ is the total market demand. OQ is the total market demand. And OM is only half of it. Okay? So this is the case. So in this way, firm A sells only OM quantity at OP price. And the remaining portion, that is, given the OQ market demand, firm B can sell the remaining quantity, that is MQ, which is equals to OM. Now let's move on to the next slide. And in this slide, we can see that if the firm B is allowed to determine its equilibrium price independently, then what would happen? Then the firm B would be in equilibrium at point EB, right? This is the point, this would be the point of equilibrium for the firm B, if it could have determined its product price, its price independently. So in that case, what would happen is OH would be the price and ON would be the quantity demanded. However, due to their homogeneous products, they cannot charge different prices. Now look at the equilibrium price of firm B. It's OH, and for the firm A, it's OP. Right? So profit maximizing price, OP, of firm A is lower than the profit maximizing price, OH, of firm B. Here, firm A will dictate the price, because its price is lower than firm B's price. So firm A emerges as a price leader, and the firm B will be the follower. So it will follow the price and sells OM quantity. It should be noted that both firms should have earned profits at the price determined by the low-cost firm. So in this way, price and output are determined under the price leadership by low-cost firm. Now we are going to discuss about the numerical problems of this price leadership by low-cost firm in the next video. Okay, I'll provide you the descriptions of the the link of the video in the description box, so you can go to the to that link so that you can see the numerical problem of this price leadership by low-cost firm. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you very much.